Very good morning, children. So today we are going to learn about adjectives in this video. Okay, what is an adjective? We have learned this in our previous classes also. What is an adjective, children? The words which describes a noun or a pronoun, which says something or which gives additional information about a noun or pronoun. They are called as adjectives. See here, what is an adjective? It is nothing but a describing word. Okay, so you will understand this through an example. What does it describes? It is a describing word. For example, rose is a beautiful flower. Okay, rose is a beautiful flower. So here we are talking about a flower, that is rose. Rose is noun and the word beautiful is describing this rose. Isn't it, children? The word beautiful, it is saying something about this rose. So this beautiful is called as adjective. So beautiful is the word which is describing a rose. Okay, so tiger is a wild animal. Tiger is a wild animal. So here we are talking about tiger. Tiger is noun. And what is the describing word here? Wild. Because the word wild is saying something about tiger. It is giving some additional information about the tiger. So tiger is a wild animal. Wild is adjective here, because wild is describing a tiger. So this type of describing words is called as adjective. Okay, children. Okay, the food was delicious. Okay, we are talking about the food here. How was the food, children? Delicious. So delicious is adjective. So what the describing words, the words which describe noun or a pronoun. So let us take one more example. He is an intelligent boy. Here we are talking about a boy. We are talking about a boy. And this word intelligent, it is describing about this boy. It is saying something about this boy. So intelligent is an adjective. So this is about adjectives, children. So the words which describe a noun or pronoun, they are called as adjectives. And we use these adjectives in comparing. Okay. In comparing, in comparison. Okay. So those are called as degrees of comparison. So let us learn about it, children. So now we are going to see about degrees of comparison. So degrees of comparison is possible through adjectives. So let us see what are the three degrees of comparison. What are the, children? The first one is positive. The second one is comparative. And the last one is superlative. So these are the three degrees of comparison. Okay. So let us see this with an example. As I told you, so positive. Let us take an adjective here. Let us take an adjective. Raju is a tall boy. Okay, the first example is Raju is a tall boy. So we are talking about Raju here. Raju is a noun. And what is the adjective here, children? Tall is adjective. Because the word tall is saying something about Raju. So when we are talking about only one person, we use this positive degree. Let us suppose the next one is comparative degree. When we are comparing or two things or two places, whatever it may be. So here as I have taken it about a person. What is positive when we talk only about one person, one thing or one place or one animal? Okay. Raju is a tall boy. We are talking only about one person. When it comes to comparative degree, we compare, the comparison is between two. Okay, Raju is taller than Shyam. We are comparing Raju with Shyam. Okay, the comparison is between two people. Okay, when in comparative degree, what is the form we use here? What are the changes we have to do? We have to add ER children to the positive degree. What is the positive here? What is the adjective? Tall. To the given adjective, we have to add ER and make it this. What is taller? Then the comparative degree. It should be followed by then. Taller than. So this is the comparative degree. When it comes to superlative degree, when the comparison is between more than two. Okay, the comparison between more than two. So how should be the example here? Raju is the tallest boy in the class. Raju is the tallest of all in the class. So what is the superlative, children? I told it is more than, the comparison is between more than two people. So here we have compared the Raju and Shyam and told that Raju is taller than Shyam. But coming to superlative, the comparison is among more, two, more than two. Okay, when the comparison is between, not in between, when the comparison is among more people. See here, Raju is the tallest of all in the class. So, in the superlative degree, to the adjective we add EST and it is followed by OF of, tallest of. Here, we are comparing Raju with all the other children in the class. Okay, so what is positive, children? When we talk about only one person, it is positive. When we compare that one with only one, when the comparison is between two persons, two places, two things or two animals, it is comparative. When it comes to superlative, when the comparison is among more people, more places or more things. For example, let us take one more example. And let us suppose Jammu Kashmir is a cool place. Let us suppose we are talking about place here. Here Jammu Kashmir is a cool place. When we compare the, when we are using that in comparative degree, let us compare with Hyderabad. What do we say? Jammu Kashmir is cooler than Hyderabad. Okay. Then while writing in superlative degree, how do we write? Jammu Kashmir is the coolest of all the other states. So this is about the degrees of comparison, children. Hope you have understood. Now to go through your textbook and go through the table in your textbook, which is about positive, comparative and superlative degrees. Go through the examples, children.